Emily.
Emily, get out of the road! Putting it on recorder, get out of the road!
We haven't had any rain all week here, so it shouldn't be a
problem. Darren?
What?
Get fully papa.
Yeah, staying around here.
They're getting better slowly.
Oh, can this take me home? That is Darren.
That's Darren.
Darren Jeans.
Second sheet.
I think he's stalled it because he isn't moving.
He's got to wait.
You can go now.
No, he can't.
You can go as soon as our dad is off the train. Retreat. Darren Jeans, please go. Retreat. After this one, it just says it away.
Yep, going back. That's going to be totally different. So what's going to happen? Yeah. Yeah, stay up in the water and stop on down here. Just if you want to get down more, I want down the side to it.
Drinking white.
straight, using both the pole and the brake, and just pulling it down to the ground instead of going through there sideways. Because sweeping corners, what happens, you get to a point where it's either too much or too less, and to get yourself out of trouble in forward dives, you just put a quick down. So you get to the point where you've either gone too far, and you're in your mind going, well, what do I do now? I'm going to put more power in, keep it going, or I'll jump on the brake. As soon as you jump on the brake, it's going to go behind there. So that's why your left foot brake, and it just pulls the car to the ground. It gives you more forward grip. It's just using your left foot, right, and just put a little bit of pressure on while accelerating. And it takes you, because your brain says, well, this one's foot and the clutch in. So it's just the weight distribution, because usually you're whacking on it because you're just pushing the clutch in. So it's just, the easiest way to teach people left foot brake is get them to do it in the car while they're going down the freeway.